Lord, hallelujah. Thank you for that reminder. My sister in Christ always lets me know. Sister Nurjahan keeps me on track. She said you forgot to turn on the recording and you forgot to turn on the live stream. So thank you, my sister. I think that was Nurjahan. Somebody sent me a text. Amen.
Yes, ma'am. That was me.
She keeps me. Hallelujah. Reminder. My sister in Christ always lets me know. Now I've got to turn my message off because I'm live in the YouTube and it was feeding back. Okay. Amen. Amen. Sister Toni, praise us with your voice. Praise God with your voice. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. I think we are at 1 o'clock, 10, 11, 12. 1 o'clock your time. It is 10 o'clock today. I hope no one walks in. I am sneaking around in the back of the church, but I am so proud to be a part of you today. I might be singing. Maybe if I do it that way, I'll be looking more at you. I felt like I was looking sideways. Sea to shining sea, song that is meaning a lot to all of us because of who you are. I mean, we have loved ones in our lives. We have sisters and brothers that have been slapped in our lives because of genetics. But then there are those that are in our lives because of who they are. Now, it's your banker. It's because of who they are, right? Money. There are some other people in our lives because they're the mechanic and they can keep your car running. But Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nisi and Jehovah Shalom. He is my peace, my provider. In the middle of all of this, he quiets us in the middle of the storm. So he's my savior because of who he is. Can you hear the music? Okay. Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Because of who you are, I give you glory. Oh, because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Jehovah Jireh, you're my provider. Jehovah Nisi, the Lord, you reign in victory. Jehovah Shalom, oh, you're my Prince of Peace, and I worship you because of who you are. Because of who you are, I give all of my glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise.
because of who you are, I will live my life and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Jehovah, you're my provider. Jehovah Nisi, bless you, reign in victory. Jehovah Shalom, my God, you've been my Prince of Peace, and I worship you because of who you are. Lord, you know you've been my provider. Thank you, Lord, because you reign in victory. Jehovah, Lord, when the world's going crazy, in my Prince of Peace, and I worship you. Yes, I worship you because of who you are. Yes, I worship you. I worship you. I bow to you. Everlasting power. I worship you. I worship you. Because of who you are.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Praise God. We can open our mics for a moment and give God some glory right here. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise Him. We worship Him. Hallelujah. Just because you're good, God. Just because you're wonderful, God. Just because you love us, God. Just because you are. Hallelujah. We worship you. You are all that we need, all that we can ever desire. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you want to say a word,
I want to introduce you to someone, though. While I was singing, Apostle Duane Spencer almost brought him in. This is my praise and worship leader right here.
Hallelujah.
This apostle is a bad anointed cat right here, I'm telling you. And he loves the Lord. And he walked through the door, and I said, I didn't want any interruptions. I wasn't interrupted. He peeked in, gave me a thumbs up, but then he jumped in the spirit with us. So from sea to shining sea, we are worshiping right now in the name of Jesus.
God bless you, Papa.
Yes. If you want to say a quick praise unto the Lord, amen. We open the floor. Listen, we don't stop God from doing what God gonna do. Go ahead. If you want to say a word or two, John.
Listen, God is doing some powerful things in these last days. I know you can witness to this, but he's breaking down all kinds of walls of divisions for the body of Christ, that he would be glorified in a great way. The dead shall rise again, not only in the last days, but we will begin to see what he's doing in these days, because the power of God is manifesting upon each of our lives as believers. Those that love the Lord, he's manifesting in such a great way. Yes, we'll see limbs grow out again. Yes, the blind eyes will come open. And yes, the dead shall rise spiritually and naturally. And so these things will happen because we are here in this season, in this time. We are not dead with COVID because of what he has upon our lives and the mission that's before us. I'm not going to continue, but I'm sure I bear witness. We have bear witness with this thing. Well, God will be glorified in these end times. God bless you. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, man of God.
Hallelujah. Right. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you so much for letting me praise with you from sea to shining sea. I'm going to head out to rehearsal in church, but y'all have got me to the point they might have to tie me down today.
Amen, amen. We love you, Sister Toni. We'll talk with you later. Thank you again for lending the gift that God gave you for our blessing. Amen. Hallelujah. Ooh, yes, 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 yes. I'm seeing all kinds of comments. Amen. Beautiful voice. Thank you, Sister Toni. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to continue on. Hallelujah. I believe. My spirit is running around this room. Hallelujah. I'm checking here to see if our dance. Hallelujah. It's time for our worship. We're going to continue this worship. Do y'all hear what I'm saying? We're going to continue in this worship. Praise God. Hallelujah. And as I said, we've gone from the East Coast to the West Coast. Now we're flying north. Glory be unto God. And I will have to share that Elder Francine Hunt, hallelujah, powerful worshiper in spirit, anointed intercessor, and praise God, she's my blood kin as well. Glory be to God. So we're kin in spirit and we're kin in natural blood. Glory be unto God. So I will open the floor for Sister Francine. Are you ready? I see Jan's. I'm waiting. Okay. Would you keep on praising while they were setting things up? Amen. I don't see you. I hear you, but I don't see you.
As I look around and now I see all the lights your hands have worked, we are snakes of you, and how your love will never fade, your words cannot hold what I feel inside. I can't describe your glory deeper as a trophy. This is where I'll do. I lift my head and my door. You're holy, Lord. You're holy, and we lift you up and magnify your name. You're holy, Lord.
Why would you
can be so much, much bigger. How you suffer. God, for me, way back on Calvary, but I pray.
Beautiful. Hallelujah. Thank Hallelujah. You, Lord.
Glory be to God. Beautiful. Come on, somebody. Give God more praise. Amen. I know the bad words was low, but that's all right. We Amen. Got the verses right there. Hallelujah.
Come on. Come on.
Glory.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Oh,
Holy. Is your name. Hallelujah.
Wonderful.
In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Strong deliverer. Glory. Listen, it's been all about him. Hallelujah. Yes. Listen Hallelujah. To what God is doing in here today. He yes. said, look at me. Glory yes. be to God. Ah, yes, Lord. Anointed praise, it says. Hallelujah.
Come on, come on, yes.
I'm looking anointed. At the messages. Anointed praise. Praise Amen. Our God. Yes, yes, yes. And can you feel, can you understand? God is calling for Ooh. Us to pay attention today. Yes. Praise God.
Today. Yes.
Holy is our Lord. Hallelujah. Holy yes. is our God. Hallelujah. He's a wonderful counselor. He's mighty in battle. He's our deliverer. He's our strength. He's our provider. Glory be unto God. Listen, it's because of who he is. And who is he? He is all those things that God said.
Oh, yes.
God is doing what God is doing. Glory be to God. Mm. I'm excited. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, my cousin.
Yes.
She's my cousin in blood, but she's my sister in Christ.
Amen. And amen.
Love. Amen. Hallelujah. I love to be in her presence when she's worshiping God in dance because she takes us right there. Hallelujah. What one does with a voice, she does with her physicality. Amen. Glory be unto God. Thank you, my cousin. Thank you, Elder Francine Hunt. Hallelujah. She Ooh. Is a member of Voice of Reason Ministries up in Cleveland, Ohio. Her pastor is Apostle Antonio Studemeyer. Praise God. Hallelujah. But listen, the voice is already acting foolish. But that's all right. God is good. And we all continue. Glory be unto God. That's right, Sister Marylene. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. We're going to continue to tell this story. I saw in the chats here that my apostle, Ramon Minggia is on the line. And if you can unmute, I would love if you would say a few words and just let us know that you're here. Apostle, can you unmute and say a word or two for us? Are you there?
God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
How are you? I am truly honored to be with all of you on this Saturday afternoon. Amen. And just thus far, just feasting on the appetizers that have been given in this multi-course meal have richly blessed my soul. I bid greetings to every one of you in your respective places. Amen. To my sister, to my daughter in the gospel, Apostle White, a longtime friend. I just want to let you know I'm proud of you, of your perseverance. We know that whenever we're doing a good thing for the Lord, the enemy always comes to discourage us, distract us, and destroy us. But on this day, I speak over everyone's life that is on this Zoom, watching over YouTube, that there's going to be not only a refilling of your cup, but there's going to be an overflow of God's anointing, of God's power, and of God's presence. So I am just looking forward to everything that is going on today. Amen. And I would not have missed this for the world.
Amen. Amen. We thank you for being here. Amen. Yes, his sister, his daughter, his friend. Amen. And if y'all would, I'm going to put a personal request out there, you all, if you would continue to pray for Apostle Ramon. He is an over the road truck driver. Amen. And he has been through those situations. You remember hearing a few weeks back about the snowstorm that had the truckers and the cars all stuck on I-95. Well, he was in one of those trucks and he's been, you know, stuck up north and couldn't get out of parking lots and so forth and so on. But I tell you what, he is yet committed to do what God gave for him to do. He makes his way back to Georgia so he can do as in the ministry work that he has been given with Agape. Hallelujah. Glory. And with House of, it's amazing how the Agape Fellowship, he makes sure that everything that God has given for him to do, regardless of whether he's stuck in the truck, doing it from the cab, doing it from the side of the road, whatever is necessary to make sure that God's word does not lack. He does that. Amen. And I appreciate you, Apostle Ramon, for being here with me, because I know that you have not had much sleep. So I appreciate you being here. And if you bow out, I understand. I thank God for you. Amen. And if you would, family, continue to keep him in prayer. Glory be unto God. I'm looking for now, praise God, the information that was sent to me. Praise the Lord for our next minister. And guess what? It's like hiding from me. But that's okay, because we're going to find it. And even if we don't find it, I can tell you from my heart. Where are you, Miss Keta? Praise the Lord. All your information that I pulled down has moved on me. Glory be unto God. That's okay, sis. I'm like, where is it? Where is it? I know. I guess what? Sister Marylene Mack, you are on the line. Do me a great honor and introduce, if you would, Sister Keta Adewale, because my little notes has just disappeared. Praise God. So you know what? God makes sure that there's always a ram in the bush. Minister Marylene Mack, if you would introduce us to Sister Keta, Minister Keta Adewale, I would appreciate it. Praise God.
Well, hallelujah, and bless his holy name for today, the shining and all the glory that has gone up to our Father in heaven. Father God, we just thank you for that right now. It is my honor to introduce my very, very good friend, but also my leader in the ministry of Beyond Brick and Mortar Ministries and the CSRA and internationally, where we take ministry beyond the walls of the church. We do a lot of stuff in the community around. We serve the homeless. And also we have My Sister's Couch as a part of that. Just so many things that we are doing. And she is the leader of. She's very humble, but she is on fire for Jesus. And I would like to present to some and introduce to others, Sister Minister Keta Adewale.
Thank you so much, my sister. I'm going to leave my camera off just so I get through the scripture, and then I'll turn it back on because I'm going to be down reading from another source. So I want to first say thank you so much. I thank God for the invite, Dr. Carrie. I thank you for including me in this powerful, awesome, dynamic, phenomenal conference, the Fill My Cup Conference, and what God has already done thus far. I'm truly, as I always say, I am truly excited about Jesus. I am truly excited about Jesus, and I'm truly excited to be a part of this Fill My Cup Conference. I give honor to God. I give honor, of course, to my husband. And I give honor to my pastor, Pastor William B. Blunt, my leader and my shepherd and my overseer, and also Winona Hatcher, my women's and ministry directress. So I'm going to say just a real quick word of prayer. Father God, I thank you so much for being with us, for showing up already. Lord God, for your presence. And I pray, God, that you will anoint my voice. Anoint, Lord God, the word. Anoint the teaching, the ears, and the hearing. Let us be too receptive to what you have given us, God, today to minister. Father God, let your word be heard, let your will be done, and may you be pleased, Father God, in Jesus' name. We thank you so much. Now, all right, so I want to be in compliance, and I know my sister said no restrictions, but I do want to still try to hold integrity to the time. And so my scripture today, now you all know, for those who are familiar with me, I do a lot of scriptures. So if you have of a notebook, or if you can take notes in your phone, or if you have a sheet of paper next, go ahead and begin to take some notes as we sort of go along. My scripture today is coming from Ephesians chapter 5. Now, the theme or the discussion that we're talking about, my sister said, is the shining, the shining, the shining, the shining. And the only thing I know that I want to talk about today, the shining, is the shining that comes from being the light, being the light. So we're going to start in Ephesians chapter 5. Now, it's a lengthy scripture, but I'm not coming from the whole entire scripture. I will touch on a few places, but my focus in this scripture is really going to come from Ephesians chapter 5, verses 13 and 14. All right, so the word of God says in Ephesians 5, "Be ye therefore followers of God as dear children, and walk in love as Christ also hath loved us, and hath given himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling savor." But fornication and all uncleanness and uncovetousness, let it not be once named among you as becometh saints, neither filthiness nor foolish talking nor jesting, which are not convenient, but rather giving of thanks. For this ye know, that no hope, nor whoremonger, nor unclean person, nor covetous man who is an idolater hath any inheritance in the kingdom of God, in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Let no man deceive you with vain words, for because of these things come the wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. Be not ye therefore partakers with them, for ye were sometimes darkness, but now are ye light in the Lord. Walk as children of light, for the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth, proving what is acceptable unto the Lord, and have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them, for it is a shame even to speak of these things which are done of them in secret. All right. Here we go, verse 13 and 14. But all things that are reproved are made manifest by the light. For whatsoever doth make manifest is light. Verse 14. Wherefore he said, awake, thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. All right, all right, all right. All right, so here we go, my brothers and my sisters. I thank y'all for bearing with me in the reading of the scripture. All right, let me get my camera turned on. All right, so here we go. We're just simply today, my brothers and my sisters, we're talking about simply the light, the shining. It said the shining, so we are the light that's shining. We are the light of the world, and we were designed, we were made, we were created to shine, given the example by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So here we go. According to the scripture, we know that we are living what? In some dark times. We know that we are living in some dark days, evil days, perilous times, corrupt times, disorderly times, dysfunctional times, okay? Hallelujah. We know here, according to scripture, that we need to be cautioned and pay attention when we see, according to Isaiah chapter 5 and 20, when we can see that people are calling evil good and good evil, when they're calling dark light and light dark, when they're calling sweet bitter and bitter sweet, all right? This is a time that we are living in where many believers, those who have accepted Jesus Christ, walked with him, been in fellowship with him, are starting to fall asleep, are starting now to sort of drift back into some ways that doesn't illuminate or doesn't reflect the light or the shining, all right, have begun to return back into sin and indulge in secret sin and practicing sin, identifying more with the world and with darkness than identifying with the light, than identifying with our Lord and our Savior, okay? All right, so we have been charged to be the light, the shining, the light that's shining and pointing others to Jesus in the midst of this darkness. And that brings us now directly to our text. Now, Paul here was addressing the people of Ephesus, okay? He was addressing the people of Ephesus, and here they were known for much pagan worship. They was the center of pagan worship, and they worshiped, many of them worshiped the Greek goddess Artemis, or in the Roman goddess, Diana, same God. And they were in sexual immorality, a lot of impurity and greed and obscenity and foolish talking and greed. They became idol worshipers, and that was their common practice, and that was their way of life. And in Ephesus, Paul was reminding them that such were some of you, that you too were in that darkness, and now you have been delivered. Now you have been set free, and now you are children in the light, and that we must walk as children of the light. 2 Corinthians 5 and 17 lets us know that if any man be in Christ Jesus, what? He is a new creature. Old things, behold, it says, look, pay attention to. That's what light does. Light makes you pay attention. Light gets your eye. light captivates you. Pay attention. Behold, you are now a new creature. Behold, all things have passed away. And behold, all things have become new. Why? Because you have now attached yourself to the light. You have now been in fellowship with the light. Why? Because you are now in relationship with the light, right? All right. All right. So according to the word, the Bible says that he was reminding them about letting their light shine by being good examples of what it means to follow Jesus, being a good example about what it means to be obedient to Jesus. All right. We do not share the same agenda with the world. We don't share the same value system with the world. We are the light of the world, and we are shining and exposing darkness. All right. So Paul now, continuing in this text, Paul opens this text by letting us know that there are three L's, the letter L, hallelujah, that we must implement. All right. The first L is what? Love. The love that we have for God in Ephesians chapter 5:2. The light has to start with the love. All right. With the love that we have for the Lord. Then number two, leave. We have to leave sin behind. Go to Ephesians chapter 3:7. That's all talking about the forsaking of sin and coming out of darkness and leaving that world behind. And then number three, live. We have to live in the light. We have to live in the light. So you can go back and you can reread again Ephesians chapter 5, verses 8 through 14. Now, Jesus declares in John 3:20, what did he say? He said, everyone who does evil hates the light. Huh? Everyone who does evil hates the light and will not come into the light for fear their deeds will be exposed. Verse 21 says, but whoever lives by the truth comes into the light so that it may be seen plainly, and that what they have been doing or have done has been done where? Wasn't done in the dark, wasn't done hidden. It was done in the sight of the Lord. All right. So now what I want us to pay attention to, you can write these words down. There are three Greek words here in this text. There are three Greek words, all of which mean light. Three Greek words for light in this text. Okay. I know when we think about light, we really just sort of say light, right? But here there are three Greek words for light in this text. And the first word is called phaneros. Phaneros is spelled P-H-A-N-E-R-O-S. Now, this light makes manifest whatever is in darkness. All right. It also means shining. All right. Phaneros, it also means shining. It's apparent. It manifests. It makes things evident, makes things made known or plainly recognized. Okay. Or plainly recognized. All right. Now, the second light, the second Greek word for light in this text is called phaino. Okay, the spelling of that word is P-H-I-N-O. Okay, P-H-I-N-O. All right, it actually is pronounced phaino, phaino. And it also means, guess what it means? To shine. It still means to shine. All right. It still means to shine. All right. Now, this light, however, it means the light to expose, but not judge. All right. And that's what we should be doing, the light to reveal and to expose, to bring people to the light, but not judge. Right. All right. So this light now, it means to shine and to be bright, to appear or be seen. And so this is where we get the word phenomena. All right. Phaino is where we get the word phenomena or phenomeno. Okay. To shed light. Then the third Greek word for light that's represented in this scripture is the word phos. Okay. P-H-O-S. But it's pronounced foes. And this is the light that captures and illustrates holiness. All right. This also means to shine. This also means to shine. This light is luminous. It illuminates anything. This is also indicative of anything that emits light, like a candle or a star or an angel. All right. This is also the power of understanding. This is the light of truth. This is the light of knowledge and spiritual purity. This means to see. And now this now is where we get the word photo. All right, the word photo or photograph, because actually it takes more light to capture a photo than anything else. All right, actually it takes the light. All right. And so this is where we get a chance now to illustrate and capture holiness. So now let's go back into the text of Ephesians chapter 5 and 13 and 14. And I'm going to read it and we'll be just about done. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5 and 13, but all things that are reproved or exposed are made manifest by the light. This is your phaneros. This is the phaneros light. Okay. And then it continues to go say, for whatsoever doth make manifest is light. This is your phaino. This is the phaino light. This is the phenomenal light. This is where you get the phenomena. This is to shine bright. This is to appear, to be seen. Okay. All right. And then it continues to go and say, wherefore he saith, awake, thou hast sleepeth, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. Now, this is your foes. This is your foes. This is the light that brings the capture of our holiness. Okay, so in verse 13, you get your phaneros, all right, talking about the light, talking about being made manifest, revealing, exposing, all right. In verse 13, it continues to go on. It's talking about making both things manifest. This is where you get your phaino, all right, continuing to go on. All right, and you get your foes. So these are the different types of light that are mentioned and brought out in this text. They're all still, the whole common denominator is that they all still shine, that they all still shine. They all may shine and illustrate one thing or another, but they all still shine. Why? Because we are the light and we are the shining. All right, so as we forsake darkness, and as we separate ourselves from sin, and as we live a life that pleases God with goodness and with righteousness and truth, then we now will begin to expose or reveal or make recognize or shed light upon those things, the sin around us and the darkness around us. It begins to expose the lives of others around us. Why? Because we ourselves now have to be careful, and Paul is cautioning us not to get comfortable. Be careful not to slip back, fall asleep, not to go off and go back into your old ways and doing your own things. Why? Because we were some liars. We were some deceivers. We were some fornicators. We did some foul stuff. So Paul is now saying, now we have come out of this lifestyle. We are now with that lifestyle representing what? The darkness. God has what called us to illuminate and represent the light. We are the shining. We are the shining. All right. So here we go. Now, as we continue, the thing that this light exposes, there are three C's about the lives of those around us and even in our own lives that I want us to write down. If you got your pen and paper, you can go ahead and write these down, these three C's down. Number one, it convinces. Go back and read chapter 5, verse 8. It convinces. The Bible says right there that you were once in darkness. So the only way I could have gotten out of darkness is I had to be convinced some way to come into the light. I was convinced to come into the light. And the same way that we were convinced to come into the light and be the shining is the same way that we ought to convince others to come into the light and to be the shining. And number two, it convicts. Go back and read chapter 5, verse 11. It says, having nothing to do with fruitless deeds or darkness. Why? Because there's something that should agitate me in my spirit. There's something that should convict me now when we are in darkness, that it brings a conviction on us when we have found ourselves slipping in sin or repeating sin or getting too close to sin or walking in sin, right? And the same conviction that we have is the same conviction that our light now helps to expose to those around us. It's the same light now that helps to shine and reveal, to help to cause, to be recognized and manifest in the lives of those around us, all right? Okay, all right. So then the third C is to correct. All right, go back and read chapter 5, verse 12. The Bible says, rather expose them. All right, and it didn't say to judge them, but expose them. Show them, reveal to them in the light that's shining, the error of their ways just by shining. Why? Because you look different. Why? Because you sound different. Why? Because you act different. Why? Because you be different. Why? Because you are different. You are the light. You are the light. So now you bring convincing power. You bring convincing power. I mean, convincing power and conviction power and correction power just because you are the shining. Just because you are the shining. Just because you are who God says you are. And that is the light of the world. All right. Now, sin is revealed for what it is. And the shining continues to expose the darkness. Now, Paul now is urging. I'm still in the text. Paul is urging them to become awakened. To become awakened. All right. Remember now, he was addressing believers who had been converted. He was addressing believers and remembering that they had come out of a lifestyle of sin and darkness, of an idol worship and pagan worship. He was addressing those believers. And the temptation sometimes to sit back into the bondage of sin is always there. But Paul is helping to caution us to remember that we must remain sober and alert and remain vigilant and stay in the light. Now, Ephesians 5 and 14 says, awake you that sleep and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give you light. Now, it is believed that Paul was using this metaphor to reflect back on Isaiah chapter 26, verse 19. You can go back and read it in your time. Or he was also, it was also believed that he could have been reflecting Isaiah 60 and 1. Now, Isaiah 60 and 1 says, arise, shine, for the light has come. And the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. So now we must get up. Our brothers and sisters in Christ, we must get up and emerge and come to the light. Have a repentant heart and be obedient to the Lord. This was not an opinion from Paul. This was not advice from Paul. This was not a suggestion from Paul. These were instructions. This was instructions to be obeyed and to be followed, that we cannot get comfortable and relaxed and complacent in a dark world, in a world filled with darkness. We can't revert back to that which the Lord has already delivered us from. There is no light in dead things. So that's why Paul has to tell us, wait a minute, arise and get up. There is no light in a dead thing. There is no light in dead things. There is no life in dead things. And so now when we go back into that area, in that arena, and we begin to fellowship and slip back and go back into those ways, then what does it do? It corrupts the illustration of the light. It corrupts the illustration of the shining. It corrupts the illustration that we are the light of the world, and that Jesus, when he was here, he was the light of the world, and we have the Holy Spirit living on the inside of us. And now that light is made manifest in and through us. So it corrupts now the illustration of light and to be the shining. All right. So just as during the times of Paul addressing the Ephesians, now we must ourselves address sin in our own lives and make sure that we are not living as the world. Rather, we are living as children in the light and children of the light. We don't have to imitate the world to reach the world. We don't have to imitate the world to reach the world. We just need to shine. We just need to be the shining, all right? The world needs to see something different about us. All right. That is what's going to gravitate them to us. Be compelled to the light. All right. They need to see something different, hear something different, feel, experience something different.
So we just need to shine. Now, there is a ministry in shining, and I'm almost done, Dr. White. There is a ministry in shining. There is a ministry in light. There is a ministry in us being the light. All right, and there are five S's in this ministry that we're going to talk about, and then I'll be really done. Five S's. So if you got your pen and paper, write it down. Here we go. Number one, it's the source, the ministry of the source. And who is our source? Come on now, somebody. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Our source of light can only come from our Lord and our Savior. All right, Jesus Christ, he is the only way. According to John 8 and 12, what did he say? Then spake Jesus again to them, saying, I am the light of the world. And he that followeth me shall not what? Walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. So we must now make Jesus the source. All right, all right. Then number two, light. What is the ministry of light? It has to shine. That's all we've been talking about, shining. It has to shine. It's luminous. It illuminates. Matthew chapter 5, 15 through 16 says, neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel. No, we don't do that, but we put it on a candlestick and we so that it can give light to all men, right? That's all around us. It's in the house. And then it goes on in verse 16 to say, let your light so shine before men that they could see your good works and do what? Glorify our Father, which is in heaven. All right. Once again, the light is redirecting them back to the source, the very source. Yeah, they see our good works, but they've seen the light of Christ on the inside of us. Yeah, they hear and they hearing about our good works. They see something going on different in our lives that is redirecting them right back to the source, our Lord and our Savior. All right. Another thing that I really loved about the light, as part of the ministry of the light, as part of the shining of the light, as part of us being the shining, is that they're silent. It's silent, S-I-L-E-N-T, it is silent, all right? So when you walk into your house, when you turn on the light, you don't hear light come on. When you walk into your living room, you don't hear light come on. When you walk into your kitchen and turn on the light, you don't hear light come on. All right, it is silent. Genesis 1 and 3, and God said, let there be light, and there was light. That's what the Bible says, and there was light. And in verse 4, he went on to say, God saw the light. He didn't hear it. It didn't rumble. It didn't grumble. It said God saw the light, and that the light was good. And then God, he divided the light from the darkness. And so now as we shine, it's not necessarily about always what we say, but it's about what others get a chance to see. Because sometimes we don't even have to say nothing for somebody to see something. It's about what they get a chance to observe and to see. All right. It is not really about what they had to hear, but it's a lot of times of what they saw and what we was illustrating and how we walked before them, all right? How they saw us, what did they see? How we shined before them. They saw then how we stood out. They saw how we were different. They saw how we loved our enemies. They saw how we blessed those who cursed us and how we did good to those who hated us. Come on now. They saw how we prayed for those who mistreated and persecuted us. Huh? That's what they saw according to Matthew chapter 5 and 44. They was looking at something. They was paying attention to something. And that something can only be exposed because we were shining. We were the light that was shining. All right. They saw something. They saw that when we were presented with the option of sin, how we made ourselves to be submitted to Christ, to submit ourselves unto the Lord. Huh? They saw how we submitted ourselves unto the Lord and how we resisted the enemy and how he fled from us, according to James 4 and 7. Why? Because we were showing them that we were walking in the light. Huh? We weren't walking in the darkness, but we humbled ourselves. We surrendered ourselves and we submitted ourselves to God. And we showed them what it means to be the light and to shine, to be the shining. And then how, by the grace of God, we don't even look like what we've been through. Dr. White don't look like what she's been through. Nora Jihan don't look like what she's been through. Marylene, Tamara, whoever else is on, the apostle, all right? Nicole, Katrina, Michael, you don't look like what you've been through. I I can't see your story on your face. I can't see your story on your body. You don't look like what you've been through. I don't look like what I've been through. Why? Because of the light and because of the grace of God. Huh? That we can be the shining. It was the grace of God to get us through what we had to go through and still come out with the glory of God being revealed on us, with the glory of God rising and reflecting on us. Huh? Not the darkness, not the past, not what we came up out of, not who was attached to or affiliated with. But we came out with the glory of God by the grace of God to be the shining, to be the light. Huh? And that's what we began to show. We did this in silence, though. We didn't brag about it. We didn't boast about it. We probably ain't even hardly told nobody about it. We didn't even testify sometimes about it. We just let the light shine. We just walked in what God said, let there be, and we became. Let there be, and we were. Let there be, and we still are. Huh? Because light is constant. Light is constant. Light is energy. Huh? All right. And so now they got a chance to see how we did in disputing, huh? How, because so that we could be blameless and innocent children of God without blemish in the midst of a crooked and twisted, perverse generation. Why? Because we were shining as lights in this world. So they saw something in us. They saw that which was emanating from us, that thing that we were highlighting and what was glowing and was giving off and revealing and causing to recognize, be made known. Not about me, but about him. And because he lives, he shines in me. He lives in me, he shines in me. He lives in me, he shines through me. He shines in my words. He shines in our voice. He shines even in our silence. He speaks volumes, even in silence. This now, we're still on the S's. We still are on the S's and the ministry of light, huh? The ministry of the shining. So he speaks volumes, even in our silence. Now, we got through the silence and now the light, the shining. Guess what else it does? It's part of a ministry for us. It brings separation. Yeah, separation. There's a ministry in separation. I know we have all had to go through the ministry of separation as God brought us from the darkness into his marvelous light. 2 Corinthians 6 and 14 says, what communion have light with darkness? We don't allow darkness to influence us. We must separate ourselves from the darkness. Why? How? By being obedient to God. We all have to go through a separation ministry as it relates to the light and to the shining. And then number five, the fifth thing, I said it was five S's. The fifth thing that this part of the ministry that light gives is the ministry of safety. Mm-hmm. The ministry of safety or protection. All right, so we always talk about the armor of God, the put on the whole armor of God. But go over and read Romans 13 and 12. There's an armor of light. Go on over and read Romans 13 and 12, it says, the night is far spent. The day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works, what of darkness, and do what? Let us now put on the armor of light. And we know our armor is our protection. So here, Jesus is the light that is shining through us and is causing a barrier. Causing a barrier between us and sin, causing a barrier between us and darkness, causing a barrier between us and the world. He is protecting us. He is keeping us. And we are in the safety now of the light. What happens in the light? What happens in darkness? Darkness, we stumble and we fumble. We can't see. Y'all ever got out of the bed, tried to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night? Or you ever hit that little corner on your bottom of your bed, that little piece of bed rail sometimes that might stick out? Oh, you ever, have y'all ever had it done that? You know, because it's dark. It's dark, huh? It's dark. But when we are in the light, we see. It's revealed to us. It's shown to us. And we have the safety and we have the protection of being watchful. Being discernful. Why? Because we now become the shining. We are now the shining. We now are the light. Hallelujah. That's exposing the darkness. So as I get ready to close, there are three C's I want us to remember. I want us to write down these three C's as I get ready to close, that we have to make Jesus our choice. We talked about him being our source. So we have to make him our choice. Joshua 24 and 15 said, choose this day who you're going to serve. As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. So we have to make Jesus our choice when it comes down to being the shining. All right. So when we're witnessing and we're ministering and we're evangelizing the word of God and we're living the ministry of light before others, we have to tell them that they have to make Jesus their choice. And then number two, regardless of the temptation to sin and go back into the darkness, we have to do what? Stay committed. Write down the word committed when you're talking about the shining. So we make Jesus our choice, and now we stay committed to him, to committed to God. We stay in our word. We stay in our word. We pray. You know, we fast. We find out the will of God. We find out what pleases God, according to what Paul was saying in Ephesians. We do the thing that pleases God. Huh? We're staying obedient, and we stand for righteousness. I want you all to write down and go back and read Deuteronomy 27 and 10 and Deuteronomy chapter 6 and 5. And then finally, we have to connect. Light connects each other. We're connected by light. We're connected by the energy. And we have to connect now others to Jesus. Others to Jesus. The light shines the brightest in the most darkest of situations. We shine. The world is dark right now. We are illuminating the world with our light. Why? To connect others to Jesus. All right, we need to share Jesus just as somebody shared Jesus with us, or just how we learned about Jesus through somebody else. We need to share Jesus so that they too can what? Become the shining. So we must plug them into the source. John 14 and 6 says, Jesus what? Is the way. He's the truth and he's the life. No man comes to the Father except by me. John 1 and 12 says, but as many has received him, to them gave he power to what? Become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. There is no other way. Regardless of what whoever else told you, there's another path. There's another way. There's another avenue. There's only one way. And Jesus is the way, and that's the way that we illuminate. That's the way that we shine, and we connect others to the way. We're connecting others as we shine to the light. As we connect, we're connecting others as we shine. We're connecting them to the life, which is Jesus. Now, as I close, hopefully today that you all were challenged to be the light, to be the shining, to stay in the light, and to act as the light, forsaking the darkness, and shining as the children of God. To God be the glory.
Amen. You muted, girl. I'm muted.
We need a fire extinguisher up in here.
Oh, my goodness. Unmute, Dr. Carrie. Unmute.
I'm just on fire right now, you know. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a word. And yes, Minister Keta, you are all up in mine. Glory to God. God is good. Oh,
amen.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Wasn't that some good eating? Now give God some praise right there for that word.
That was a meal.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, I was trying to scribble, but you know, she's talking fast as I do. Glory be to God. You know, I was hearing how all kind you listen. I turned the camera off because I was my face was all contorted because I was trying to write so fast. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Me too.
This walk through. Ephesians and 5, praise God, hallelujah. Yes, 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 Brother Apostle Ramon. Awesome word, huh? Yes. Did she walk it through? Did she tell you that we're living in some dark times and people are calling that which is evil good, and what is good evil, and what is bittersweet? Bitter sweet bitter, what dark is light. Oh, come on. That's exactly the description of our, not just our nation, but the world at large. Glory be to God. It is the word of God. We got a charge to be the shining. Hallelujah. Yes, Sister Tamara says, thank you, Sister Keta. That's from Sister Tamara Douglas. I've checked on the YouTube and there's a comment there, but it's in a different language. And so therefore, that's one I don't know. Praise the God. And he hasn't given me the word of knowledge on that one yet. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes. But we just know that they are watching by YouTube. Amen. Sister Nicole says, I started taking no stop to start praising God. Hey, I know
that. Amen.
Glory be unto God. Thank God that it's on YouTube. Hey, because I'm going to walk heavy. Yeah, Brother Ramon said, we're walking heavy this afternoon. Yes, we are. Hallelujah. And I love it. She said, yeah, she brought out the L's, the loving in Ephesians 5:2, the leaving in Ephesians 3. I think it was 3:7, but I was writing fast, so it might be living. Ephesians 5:8-14. She talked about, oh, now listen, she was all up in the next message where she went to talking about them words. Glory be to God. We're going to get some more into that. Hallelujah. The shining, the phaneros and the piano and the boss. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I'm not going to give a re-preach her message. I just want to make sure you guys were listening.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she talked about exposing, appearing, and shining. Are you exposing or are you appearing? And listen, I'm not going to get in my message yet. Them C's, convince, convict, correct, huh? Them S's, source, shine, silence, as separation and safety. And I added another one, Sister Keta. I added submitted. Come on,
amen.
Powerful word. Powerful word. I want to thank you for bringing that. And my soul, my spiritual babe is leaping all over the place. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We're going to take a moment. Praise the Lord. I was asking a brother friend of mine that's on the line with us, a brother, Michael Hopkins. I told you we see the shining. See, he's up there in the Virginia, Maryland, up in that area somewhere. Mm-hmm. And I've asked him if he would come, but I want to tell you and do our offering. But I want to tell you a little bit about this brother. You know, one of the things that Sister Keta was talking about is what are you doing? Are your actions showing that you're shining, right? And this brother is an advocate for veterans. So if there are any veterans that are watching this now by YouTube live, or listen, if you share it with others that you are people that you know and family members or friends that are veterans and that are having some have issues with maybe their benefits or even just with their adjusting to this society, they need to connect with Brother Michael Hopkins. He has a ministry called Vet Talk. Amen. As a matter of fact, and his angels are also on the line with us, Sister Nicole, Sister Katrina, Sister Nurtahan, and I believe one faithful member, Miss Sister Tamara. Amen. Hallelujah, Sister Keta. Right? I mean, they're faithful with helping support him in Vet Talk. And it's an internet radio show. Amen. But he gives them tips and gives them help with situations and circumstances, not just veterans, but are you the spouse, the wife, the child of a veteran? Hallelujah. That's the thing. He gives you, his ministry is to serve those, that populace that may be disenfranchised, if you understand what I'm saying. So even on the couple of days ago, he spoke with a young lady that some things had happened in her with her initial training with military, and it's been years, but he was able to, he said, I need to talk to you because there's something that can be done. Glory be unto God. So I would like to ask him if he would come on, praise the Lord, and do our offering. I just had to give him some accolades because guess what? We all have a gifting that we shine through. Amen. Hallelujah. It may not be behind a book board. Hallelujah. It may not be by a dance. It may not be by song, but we all have a gift. Amen. That shines through. Brother Michael, can you come on for me?
Hello, everyone. This is Michael Hopkins. How are you today?
Praise the Lord, brother.
Great. And Dr. Carrie, I just wanted to thank you for putting this on today. This is such a beautiful experience. It really is. I've been a little bit under the weather, but trust me, this has boosted my morale up for real, for real. And Sister Keta always got something that she puts out there. Like I always tell everybody, if we have to go to Georgia and we got to sing Midnight Train, she ain't going the way out of the organization. But this has been quite an experience today, and I've been enjoying it. I really have. And I appreciate you so much talking about Vet Talk. And it's been such an honor to be able to help other veterans like myself. It has been such an honor. And the young lady that you were speaking about, after I got to talking to her, come to find out, she is an honorably discharged veteran. She didn't know that for 20 years because nobody told her. Isn't that special?
That's why you're needed, Brother Michael. That is exactly why you're needed.
And it's so beautiful. Now, everyone, Dr. Carrie is doing such an excellent job here. It's an excellent job. And one of the things we all should do, we should contribute to her ministry. Her ministry is so important. I know to us and our group, she is a vital member of our group. I always joke with her and I tell her she can't go nowhere. I always tell her that. I said, you can't go nowhere. But she this ministry that she has, believe me, it is a vital ministry. And I enjoy the times that I spend with her and I spend with the group in her ministry because it gives me hope sometimes. Yeah, sometimes I'm dealing with the veterans, and I mean it's great, but sometimes some of the stories that they tell me is just like Dr. Carrie, when you were talking just now about that young lady, it was getting ready to make me cry. It really was. Reason being, because the things that she went through as being a service member, she shouldn't have went through. And it's happened so much. And there's so many of us that have not only physical wounds, we have mental wounds. And the wounds don't go away. And people think they go away, but they don't go away. And a lot of times, as veterans, we don't have anybody to talk to. We just don't. And so we keep it bottled in. And then one day we explode and people say, well, why did this person do that? That's the reason why, because we keep it in. But what I would love for all of us to do is to contribute to Dr. Carrie's ministry. It doesn't matter what you do, how much you contribute to it. We all should do something to contribute because she really puts her all in all into this. She really does. And if you guys could cash app her, that would be perfect. And that's $, and the rest is capital letters, R-H-O-F-I-N-C. Once again, that's Cash App, and it's $, capital letters, R-H-O-F-I-N-C. Thank you all so much. I'm looking forward to just being imbibed in all of this today. This is, it's making me feel much better today, for real, for real. Thank you so much. Turn it back over to you, Dr. Carrie.
Okay, it wouldn't unmute for me. Okay, that is so awesome, Brother Michael. We pray your continued strength in the Lord, amen, and for fullness and wholeness in your recovery, amen. We thank God that the word is healing. You know, the scripture tells us in Psalm 107:20, he sent his word and healed us of all of our distresses. Hallelujah. So the word is being sent and the word is healing. Not just you, but it's touching all of us. It's touching us in our spirit. It's touching us in our bodies, in our emotions, in our thought patterns. The word is healing. And I thank you for allowing us to be a catalyst for God's healing virtue to flow into your life. I want to read this offering declaration. Amen. Hallelujah. I was going to send it to Brother Michael So anyway, praise the Lord. So as we tithe and give our offerings today, we believe the unbelievable and receive the impossible. Heaven opened, earth invaded, storehouses unlocked, provision cascaded, resources released, miracles created, bills paid and debt eradicated, dreams, visions, visitations, declarations, impartations, and divine manifestations, anointings, giftings, and calls awakened, positions, promotions, and assignments undertaken, souls, and more souls out of every generation around the world, from every tribe, every tongue, and every nation. For this, we make this declaration in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory be unto God. So we thank you for your support of the ministry. Praise God. All right. Well, there was one other thing, and I'm checking, but I don't see that they were able to make it on. I'm going to check the names one more time. So give me just a second to see, because they were not sure if they could make it. I don't see that. Okay. They haven't made it on. So we're just going to go on and go on and go on. So again, my name is Apostle Dr. Carrie White. And I would love, you know what? You know, I don't like introducing my own self, but we just to tell you the ministry again is Refined Heart Outreach Fellowship Incorporated. And that's what the RHOFINC stands for. The giving that you give would be to the ministry. God gave me the vision for this ministry years ago when he has gifted me with a curiosity about ministry, really. And one of the things that I saw is that there were so many separations, depending upon whether you like the color blue or red or green or purple. You know what I'm saying? Things that really did not matter. There is no division in God. So when he gave me the understanding to walk in ministry and he gave me Refined Heart, it's because he changed my heart. I went through some things, as they say, we go through the fire, praise God. And when you come through the fire, then that which is, for instance, when you're smelting gold, amen, you know, it has to get into that heat so that which is not valuable, the gold rises to the top and the dross drops to the bottom, the contaminants drop down. You got to have some fire to get your heart right. You gotta, you know, the passion of the Lord, hallelujah, is where it is. And the fact that I love people, outreach, and therefore I want to bring together ministries and ministers and different genres from all different types and levels, fellowship. Amen. So here is Refined Heart Outreach Fellowship, bringing to you what filled my cup, because, you know, the more we pour out, the more we pour out, we get empty if we don't have something poured back into us. So I thank God for the Fill My Cup conferences that he even began before the ministry started, Refined Heart Outreach Fellowship. So anyway, I am the founding apostle of the ministry here in the Decatur, Georgia area. And we are, we believe in, somebody asked me, am I non-denominational or am I this or am I that? No, I'm interdenominational. There is no division in Christ. Amen. So, you know, we have those, and if you had noticed or if you had checked, you would see we have people from all different genres that are supporting this time with us today. So, That being said, I don't want to cut the fire because God is still doing it. God is still good. God is yet good. Okay, we're going to be with you for maybe another 20 minutes or so, and maybe 30, you know, whatever the Spirit does. But we won't, you know, we're just going to let God flow. Is that okay? We're just going to let God flow. Hallelujah, because there is, I had another songbird, but she wasn't able to make it, so we're just going to go forward, okay? And I'm laughing because Sister Keta was all in my message. The theme today, praise the Lord, is the shining. Yes, Sister Keta, amen. The theme is the shining, from sea to shining sea. And just as she said, God told me, no restrictions. And in that no restrictions, then we allow God his freedom to do what God is going to do. Amen. So let me pray, if you don't mind, praise God. And if we're going to do a quick word, whatever the Lord got to say, amen, and we're going to be gone. Praise God. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you for this day that you have made for us to rejoice, to be exceedingly great, glad in. I thank you, Lord God, for the ministry that you have set before us. I thank you for the time that we have had in you today. I thank you for the fire. I thank you for the reviving. I thank you for the restoring. I thank you, my God, for how you have resurrected us in your resurrecting power. Hallelujah. And therefore, you have told us to shine. Now I'm asking that you would pour your anointing on this word, Lord God, that what I say is what your children need to hear, and let it be nothing else but your voice that they hear, in the name of Jesus. And I give you praise for it, God. Thank you. I am so honored that you would allow me to represent the kingdom. It's in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen. Glory be to God. Yes, yes. I'm excited.
Ready.
Are you guys excited?
Ready, ready, ready.
Ready.
Yes.
Amen. Ready for the word. Yes.
Glory be unto God. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Folks are sending me things. I'm not sure. I was checking, because some people were having some trouble. I'm just making sure this is a ministry related. Hold on. Okay, I don't think that is, because the phone went black. And if it wasn't, God would make sure I could see it. All right, so we are talking about the shining. You know, I was telling everyone, praise God, for those of you that have never been with me before, when it comes to the word, I'm more of a teacher than a preacher. Hallelujah. But you know, I love the word and I love digging the word. I loved it. You know, my mother and I, we used to call ourselves professional students because we were always okay, we got some weird noises going on around here. I bind up all distractions right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And so, you know, we love to dig, we love to learn, we love to get the meat out of things, you know. For those of y'all that eat the crab legs, you know, you get that little pick and you start digging down in that shell and get all that meat out of there. That's me. Hallelujah. So when God gave me the theme for the, thank you, Sister Keta. She says a great teacher too. As God gave me the theme for the conference, The Shining, he gave that to me back around October timeframe. Hallelujah. Yes, it was an awesome word, Sister Katrina. Powerful word. And he gave me The Shining. I already knew the date. It's always the fourth Saturday of January. And, you know, it wasn't until a couple of weeks ago that it was confirmed. Yes, it will be virtual, because I was trying to do things the way I've done things in times. And the Lord said, you haven't been this way before. You're going to do this different. So we're doing this. And I thank God, it has been awesome. If you guys have been enjoying yourselves, right? Amen. Yeah. God has been filling us up, right?
Absolutely.
Yes, it's very good. I've enjoyed myself.
Amen. That's
thank
what
God
I'm
for. Doing. Thank God for Zooms.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
And you know, some folks say, well, you didn't go Facebook into, you didn't do it the normal way. Normally, for those that don't know, I do my services on Sunday afternoon at 3 in the afternoon. And I normally live stream into Facebook. Amen. And so I Zoom, but I also go live into Facebook at 3 o'clock on every Sunday. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And then on Mondays, I have Mentoring Mondays where we talk about biblical principles and how we in our daily living and our business lives can implement biblical principles in what we do, because we are kingdompreneurs. We are entrepreneurs with a kingdom mindset, okay? Connecting profit to kingdom purpose. So the group that Brother Michael was talking about is a group that I founded, Kingdompreneur Fellowship Group, because the Kingdompreneur Group, we are about doing business the right way, okay? Whatever that business happens to be. We have network marketers. We have people that have brick and mortar stores. We have people that are in different professions. Hallelujah. But we all are about what we do, kingdom minded and in a kingdom way, according to biblical principles. We're spiritually minded. We are not religious. Amen. We don't put restrictions on all of that, except that you will know we're going to name the name of Jesus. Praise our God. Hallelujah. You don't have to name it, but we are, because that's where we come from. Hallelujah. And so when I got to this conference and God was saying, you're going to do this thing a little different. You know, you never been this way before. One, we're going virtual. Two, he didn't give me my word. He didn't give me a scripture. I usually know what scripture. I've got my little program together. I've got my folk. I've got everything on. You know, I'm one of those little people that like to get into the details. I'm more of a, you know, perfectionist. I do desktop publishing. So, you know, I usually have my booklet and I've got my bags and I got my this and my that. And none of that happened this time because God said, you ain't been this way before. Hallelujah. So how about God waited until the wee hours of the morning to share with me what it is that he wanted me to talk about? Mrs. Keta and I were laughing about it. She was saying that she got her message earlier this morning too. And I told her I went to bed at 6 a.m. Mm-hmm. And because God had me up all night in this word, and I was laughing because she started in it, but it was interesting that in all of that teaching, she didn't go where God sent me. Again, no restrictions. Can you just rely on God? Can you just trust God to lead you in the way that you should go? Hallelujah. So that's what, oh, well, things are falling over now. That's okay. Hallelujah. If you would, and I need my specs, y'all, okay? If you would, if you have your Bibles, turn with me to 1 Corinthians, I believe. Hold on. Mm-hmm. 2 Corinthians, I do apologize. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Amen. And what's so interesting about Corinthians is that, 1 Corinthians anyway, that Paul wrote, yes, just like Paul wrote the letter to the Ephesians, Paul also wrote the letter to the Corinthians. But what was interesting about it is, at least 1 Corinthians, he wrote it from Ephesus. Mm-hmm. And why Corinthians? Corinthians was the Corinth, the city of Corinth, is another one of those major cities. It's another one of those metroplexes. It's another Atlanta. It's another Miami. It's another Portland. Mm-hmm. It's a major hub for trade, amen. And this 2 Corinthians letter, Paul wrote the first one to the Corinthians because they were going through some stuff, and he wanted to share some information with them about their faith. Their moral character in Corinth was a fertile ground for them to get the news about the Messiah, right? He had to write a second letter. You know, sometimes we don't quite get it all right the first time. I'm just saying. So, you know, if you haven't got quite the fullness of the shining of, you know, as Sister Keta went through all of those things that we need to be convinced, convicted, and corrected, amen, that we have to recognize our source, shine, be silent about it, and make sure we get, you know, separate ourselves from the things of the world, from the darkness there, and to rely on the Savior, how we have to love, we have to lead, and we have to live, amen. So, you know, sometimes we just don't get it all together in the first session, praise God. But he wrote a second letter because a crisis had appeared and he had sent Titus to Corinth, right? And because he had heard that there were certain abuses happening There were certain things that were happening, and he wanted to encourage the believers. He wanted to warn them of some dangers. You know, he knew he was going to have to be a little stern with some folk. Hallelujah. That there were some people that were out and they were trying to trash his ministry. They were trying to trash him. Amen. They were trying to promote themselves instead of promoting the gospel. You see, we've got to let our light, as Sister Keta says, so shine before men that they see our good works and glorify who? The Father, not us. Glory be unto God. That said it again, the Father, not us. God's going to, I feel it already. God's going to tell me a different way. But amen. So here we are in the second epistle to the Corinth, or the second letter that was written to Corinth. You know, he's sending them another message. Hallelujah. And it says that this one is the most personal of all Paul's epistles, right? And if we look carefully, we'll see that sometimes he's in joy and sometimes he's in despair. And you know what? That's our walk with Christ. Sometimes we can be so, you know, we're on Mount Moriah, and sometimes we're on Mount Oreb. Ah, glory be unto God. Sometimes we're at the Mount of Olives, and sometimes we're at Mount Carmel. Glory be to God, because our situation, our experiences change. One second. Amen. So let's go on with the word. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Hallelujah. And I'm going to read it real good, but our main verse is going to be chapter 4, verse 6. But I want to read up to that, all right, quick, okay? Therefore, since we have this ministry, as we receive mercy, we do not lose heart, but we renounce, one second, I'm laying hands on my own throat. Father, in the name of Jesus, let your healing virtue flow. Remove all distractions, interruptions, aggravations, and irritations. Heal me now, in Jesus' name. One second, guys. Oh, my goodness. That'd be a good word.
Lord Jesus, I bind that cough in Jesus' name. Jesus' name, come out of you. Father. Father, let us hear the word that you have for us. Lord, Lord,
my God,
your
my
mercy,
God.
Your grace.
My God, my God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, thank you, Jesus.
We'll wait on him. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, thank you. Oh, my Lord, my Lord, my Lord, my Lord.
Hallelujah.
I trust you. I rely on you.
Yes, Lord.
I wait on you, Father. I wait on you, Father. I know you'll do it. I know you'll do it. Bring the voice back. Bring the voice back. Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. I wait on you, Lord. There. Yes, God. I appreciate you, Father. Yes, hallelujah. Lord. I trust you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you,
yes,
Father.
Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Come on, Lord. Come on, Jesus.
Glory be unto God.
Have your way.
Glory be unto God. Glory. Glory.
Give her strength right now. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus. Y'all, excuse me a minute. I got to give God some glory.
Yes,
hallelujah,
yes,
Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. See, only God can turn around, turn the thing around. Mm. Praise God. Hallelujah. Where my glasses go? They went flying. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be unto God. I thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So we going on back. We not letting nothing stop this word. Praise God. If I had to type it, we going to get this word. Amen.
No.
Glory be unto God. Therefore, since we have this ministry, as we receive mercy, and I just did, y'all, praise the Lord, we do not lose heart, but we have renounced the things hidden because of shame, or as the King James says, dishonesty. Mm-hmm. Not walking in craftiness or adulterating the word of God. Hallelujah. Amen, Sister Sherry. The devil is a lie. He will not bind this word. Mm-hmm. But by the manifestation of truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience, what? In the sight of God. And even if our gospel is veiled, and I think the King James says it's hidden. Huh? It is veiled to those who are perishing, in whose case the God of this world has blinded the minds of the unbelieving, that they might not see the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For we do not preach ourselves, but Christ Jesus as Lord, and ourselves as your bondservants for Jesus' sake. For God, who said, light shall shine out of darkness, is the one who has shown in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ. Amen, amen. Now, I read it to you out of the New American Standard Version. It's the one of the first editions of the New American Standard Version, because you know what, they've updated it, but that's the old one. I like the first version. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to talk a little bit about this shining. Mm-hmm. You know, I was looking at the word shining. God told you, God gave me the theme back in October. And it was interesting that about a week ago, I was checking out the you know, taking a break, and I was watching and looking at the TV, what do you call it, where it rolls up and tells you what all is on the TV. And what usually what I do, if I'm going to take a break, I will go to the guide, that's the word I was looking for, go to the guide, flip to the one where it says just movies, and then search through the movies to see if there's a movie I can see. Because I don't want to get caught up in a series, because if I get watching a series, I'm going to sit there all day long. So I know that the movie's going to have a beginning and an ending, and then I can get up and go on about my business. Well, I noticed that the movie that was playing was The Shining by Stephen King. Hmm. And over the course of about a week, that movie played over and over and over and over. And I'm like, okay, God, what are you trying to tell me? Now, you told me The Shining, but I didn't think you were talking about that kind of shining. What are you trying to say? And what he was confirming for me is not so much about the guru, the horror and all of that stuff that was there, but the message within it. Hallelujah. The message being that, as Sister Ikeda even brought it out, you have to recognize what your source is, that shine, others can recognize it even if your mouth don't move. Mm-hmm. And it can cause you to be separated, and cause you to separate yourself from your surrounding. So what I was noticing about the movie, The Shining, no, I didn't watch the movie. I saw it years ago when I was back in them days and liking that kind of craziness. Mm-hmm. But I don't get too off. I don't get into that craziness now. Back in the day when I didn't understand, you know, he said you were in times past in darkness, right? So back in that day, I watched the movie. So I know what's about the movie. Amen. So, you know, The Shining, according to Scatman Crothers, you know, who played Doc, brother, I think his name was Holloman or something. Anyway, he basically told the boy, he said, you know, he could communicate with him without talking. So it was a mixture of telepathic ability and clairvoyance. He knew the past, and he could see the future, and he could communicate without using words. How about that? I don't want to get ahead of myself in my message. But anyway, that's another thing about shine. You know, Sister Keta gave us all of that beautiful, I mean, that was powerful information about shining and how we are to rise and shine, for our light is coming. The glory of the Lord is risen up on us. Amen. But you know what? In today's culture, you know what she said, what she talked about, I believe it was Isaiah. Excuse me, which one was it? Wrong script, wrong side. Hold on. Isaiah 5:20, I believe it was, where it says where they call good evil good and good evil. Well, guess what? They have changed the word to shining, because if you say something today to certain groups of people, to shine means when you lie, when you're being rude, when you're being betraying people, to pass up on an offer. You know, they say to shine one on is to deceive one and tell a lie, to deflect or avoid responsibility for something. Uh-huh. So again, even in today's culture, the word shine, shining, hallelujah, they're trying to flip the meaning, uh-huh, to something dark. But no. We who are believers, we look for the truth of the shining. Well, let's look at verse 6, 2 Corinthians 4 and 6. Now, we're going to talk a little bit about those earlier verses, but we're going to talk about 4 and 6 real quick. I'm keeping watch on the time. Hallelujah. For it is the God who said, let light shine out of darkness, who has made his light shine in our hearts. The light of the knowledge of God's glory shining in the face of the Messiah Yeshua. Mm-hmm. Okay, we're going to break that word, that verse down, because there is some meat, glory be unto God. We're going to take that pick and pull all that crap meat out of that shell. Amen. For it is God, one said, for Theos, hallelujah, divinity, deity, hallelujah, praise God, commanded. Let's stop with that right there. Commanded, glory be unto God. That word is epo. It means to command, to grant, to say a thing, hallelujah. And I remember back in Isaiah 55:11, it said, so is my word that goes forth out of my mouth. It will not return unto me unfulfilled, but it will accomplish what I intend and cause to succeed what I sent it to. Now that's the complete Jewish Bible's translation, okay? I have several translations and my folk know this. I may be in one translation, another translation. I like a lot of them, amen. And some make the scripture a little more clear than others. And I love how they say it in the complete Jewish Bible. It says, so God is speaking. It's him speaking, his deity, his Theos that is speaking. And he says in Isaiah 55:11, so is my word that goes forth out of my mouth. It will not, in King James, it says, it will not return unto me void, but it will accomplish the thing whereunto I sent it. So when God commanded, it has to happen. Okay? There's no stopping it. There's no blocking it. There's no distractions. There's nothing that can stop what God has commanded to be. And what did he command? Hallelujah. He commanded the light. For God, who commanded the light. And that is one of those words that Sister Keta talked about. Amen. That phos, P-H-O-S, is an obsolete word that means to make manifest, to bring it out, right? To break forth. The luminosity of, he commanded the brilliance, the luminosity, the loom. You know what? How do they count how bright a light is? They count the loom, the lumens, L-U-M-E-N. Mm-hmm. Or the candle power. Uh-huh. So how bright a light is and how much it dispels the darkness is by a measure of lumens. God has commanded the fullness of lumen. Hallelujah. The light, the lamp, it's emitted by a lamp. Hallelujah. Anything that emits that light, God has commanded it to be. He says, you know, it could be a fire, it could be a torch, it could be a lamp. God is light. Hallelujah. But he has commanded false. He has commanded what? The power of understanding. That's what another version, and she mentioned that, Sister Keta said it, is understanding, is knowledge, is truth, is seeing, is being made manifest. God has commanded the power of understanding. If God says it, if he sent it out, it came forth from his mouth, it has to be. There is no stopping it. So God has commanded, hallelujah, the power of understanding, and the power of understanding to do what? For God who commanded the light, folks, to shine, lampo. That's the word, Greek word lampo, L-A-M-P-O. And it means to radiate brilliancy. It means to give light, to shine, to beam. Hallelujah. God has said, I need the power of understanding to radiate. Ah, glory. Somebody come on here with me. But God has said it will go for, it will happen. You can't stop it. The power of understanding will radiate. Why? Let's stop right here. Why did he say it there? What is Paul talking about? Because in two verses earlier, he said that the God of this world has blinded the minds of the unbelievers so that they would not understand. They would not receive the knowledge, the light of the understanding, the power to understand, hallelujah, the lampo of the origin, the movement of the light, the knowledge, the understanding of God. But who has he blinded? The unbeliever. So believers, understand. He can't stop you from understanding what this word is going to tell you in this scripture. See, we look at this one and we don't quite get all the meat out of it. But let's keep going, because you're going to see where I'm going with this in just a minute. God, who commanded the light, the force, the power of understanding to what? Shine, the brilliance to radiate, to beam what? Out of. Why am I stopping with that? That word out of is a Greek word, ek, ek. Why is that important? Because you have to recognize that this is a motion word. It says out of, from, it's movement, it's continuous. It's not a one-time thing. It's going on and on and on and on and on and on. Hallelujah. From glory to glory, to history in your life. Hallelujah. For God, who commanded the light, the power of understanding to radiate, to beam out of, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep doing. Hallelujah. Out of what? Darkness. And we think darkness, we think dark, light, lapses of light. You can't see. But that word darkness there is skotos. It means obscurity. It's not that you can't see. It's not completely pitch black. It's not the movie Pitch Black. It's not where you can't see nothing. It's where you see through a mirror dimly, where you see darkly, where things are obscure, where you're not getting the full picture, where you're getting kind of messed up, where things are contaminated, where things have some extra stuff has been added, where too much salt has been put in the stew and it's too salty to eat. You won't stop me. You won't block me. Thank you, Father. Obscurity, ignorance when it comes to divine things. God has commanded the beaming of understanding to come out of the ignorance of divine things. Come on, somebody. Do you understand? You can understand the commands of God. You can understand the word of God. You can understand the move of God in your life if you would what? Believe him. That's all you got to do. All right, come on. Let's go on. Let's go on. I'm almost done. Hallelujah. So God has commanded the light to shine out of the obscurity, the ignorance of the divine things, the ungodliness and immorality. He has, God has commanded light to shine out of that, to come forth from that, move, as she said, separation, hallelujah, it's time to come forth, hallelujah, it's time to break out, hallelujah, arise and shine, for thy light has come. Heart, he said, awake thou that sleepest, hallelujah, Jesus. So he's commanded the light to shine out of darkness. He is the one who commanded. So when did he do this command? Back in Genesis 1:3. What? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Back in Genesis 1:3, he commanded the power of understanding to come out of the darkness. Come on, somebody. So it's been there from the beginning. Glory be unto God. Hallelujah. And we have to understand that the first man, Adam, had access to all of this wonderful knowledge and understanding of God. But because he doubted God's word, he moved into the era of unbelief, and then that's the God of this world blinded him. Well, we're gonna go on. Come on. I got more to tell you. Hallelujah. So God, who commanded the light to shine out of the darkness, what has he done? He has shined. So he commanded it to happen, and then he caused it to happen. Hallelujah. That lampo again. Mm-hmm. And then he caused it to shine, but in. We were first out, now we're in. Uh-huh. It came out of the darkness of obscurity, and now it's shining into something. The word in is en. Out was ek, ek, in is en. Why is that important? Because again, it's a word that is saying a place of rest. Out of was movement. It was continual movement. It's steadily happening. But he says to shine in to a fixed position, to a place of rest, a stationary, to where you get it and it ain't going nowhere. Ha, glory be unto God. Ah, yes, yes, yes. See, in the en here, it stands between the ek, which is a motion out, and the s, E-I-S, which is motion into. But the en, think about it. Let me give you an idea. Those of us that like to cook, we grab that measuring cup, right? And we pour out of one container into the cup. As it's pouring, there is motion. But once it is in our cup, it is stationary. That's the en. God is saying, I'm filling your cup and I need for it to stay in the place that I put it. And where did he put it? Like a lamp in the heart. Hallelujah, for God has shined in our hearts, in our cardia. Hallelujah. Cardia here is spelled with a K instead of a C. Hallelujah. It is our thoughts. It's the seat of our feelings. Hallelujah. It is the middle. It's the seat of our impulses, our affections, our desires, our intellect. Hallelujah. In our mental frames, in our conscious. Hallelujah. It's that organ, which is the seat of life. The circulation is in the center of our body. It's the center part of our spiritual and our physical life. Come on, somebody. It is the seed of our spiritual life. And God has commanded the understanding, the power of understanding, the luminosity of his word to come out of obscurity and to rest in our hearts. That is good. Ha! Yeah, yeah, yeah. So here, God, the Theos, has commanded light to shine out of the darkness, to shine into the center of who we are. Come on, somebody. May he says, you got to make me your priority. You got to give me your whole heart, your whole mind, your whole understanding.
Come on, Dr. White. Come on.
It's in the center. And he has commanded this understanding, this power of understanding to rest in our heart, to stay there. Hallelujah. It's not moving in and through. It's coming into our cup and it's hanging out. Glory be unto God. And what is it that why is it that we need this understanding to rest, to remain, to be locked down in our hearts, to give the light, to give the light. He's shining the light in to give the light. Well. Understand that the two word there is pros. Now we're back into movement. Wait a minute. Well, if the light is supposed to come in and stay, what is the two? Why is the movement now? No, we're gonna get there because that word is pro, and that is a word that says from something proceeds from our heart are the issues of life. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. What are you giving out? Well, come on, let's give the light. What light? That light there is Potomos, as she was saying. I know I'm not sure if you gave that one, but anyway, Photimos. The accent is almost. And like she said, it's from the word where we get the word photo, right? It means illumination. It means light, the act of enlightenment, the act of brightness, the act of brilliance, bright light, to brighten up, to make known, huh? To cause something to exist, to cause something to come clear, to cause something to inform, to instruct, to teach, to give understanding to. God has given us the power of understanding and for the brilliance of his light, of his knowledge to rest in our hearts. Why? So that we can give out and instruct and inform and to teach the knowledge of his God. Come on, somebody. We're going on.
Come on.
To give the light of what? The knowledge. The knowledge. The word knowledge is gnosis. Well, sometimes they get to add that Gnostic word. Basically, some people worship knowing, but God said, no. Don't worship knowing. Give knowledge. Give knowing. What is knowing? You know, that word is in here 28 times, and sometimes, one time only, it was written as translated as science. Oh, somebody come with me. 1 Timothy 6:20, he told Timothy, keep that which is committed to thy trust. Turn away from the ungodly babblings and the argumentative opposition of what is falsely called knowledge, falsely called science. Don't get yourself all up in a debate about stuff that does not matter. That is not where the life-saving light is. Hallelujah. We are not worried about denominations or demarcations. We are about being interconnected with heart to heart, breast to breast as we serve our God. Follow me as I follow Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That, and he says that right now we are to give knowledge. What? That gnosis means it's a present, but it's a fragmented knowledge. We don't have the whole truth yet. We're not going to have the fullness. We see through a mirror dimly. Scripture tells us, 1 Corinthians 13, we know in part. Our knowledge is partial. We don't have the whole story, so it's no sense arguing with nobody. You don't have the whole answer anyway. Come on, somebody. We see through a mirror darkly, we see in part, but at a time, at the right time, at the opportune time, at the appointed time, we'll have all the knowledge we need. We'll see him face to face, and everything we ever thought we needed to know, we'll know. And that's without moving our mouth. Yeah, that's with being in connection with the one that can speak to us without moving our mouth. Mm-hmm. That's the one, that's the connection where we'll know the past and we'll understand the future, because at that time we'll know all things. Yeah. The power of knowing, the power of intelligence, the power of comprehension. So right now, our love, you know, it says we can't comprehend the love of God. We can't fathom it. We can't figure it. We can't hold it all. We don't understand. We cannot fully comprehend how awesome our God is, because of who you are. I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice in praise and I worship you. Why? Wow. Just because of what I know about you. But I don't know everything yet, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I know that you're holy. Yeah. I know that you're Jehovah Jireh. I know you're Jehovah Shalom. Yeah. I know you're Jehovah Nisi. But I don't know everything about you yet.
Yes.
Hallelujah. But God has shined in our heart and said, let it rest in there so that we can give out what little bit we do know. Oh, thank glory you. Be unto God.
Thank
Hallelujah,
you.
Lord. Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord. The glory word of God is unfolding. That word of knowledge is unfolding. It's expounding. It's the key. Hallelujah. It's not static. It's changing from glory to glory, revelation to revelation. We're in continual illumination, layer upon layer, line upon line, precept upon precept, here a little and there a little. We can't know everything on this side of eternity. But when we get up to the other side, we are right now continually in the shining. Hallelujah. The coming of knowledge, the sensitivity to revelation of that which others cannot see and cannot understand. And what is it that we come to understand and reflect? Come on, somebody. The knowledge of the glory. Hey! Glory, the kabah, the doxa. The Greek word is doxa. Hallelujah. But the Hebrew word is the kabah, the weightiness, the abundance, the treasure, the value of God. Have you come to know the fullness of your God yet? Or do you know the honor, the dignity, the splendor, the majesty, the glorious attributes of your God, the perfections of our God, the bliss of our God? We are to come to the place where we are giving out the knowledge, the understanding, hallelujah. As we know him, we share him. We don't know the fullness of him, and how I may share him may be different than how you share him, because guess what? Your knowledge of him may be different than mine. I know him in the healing power. I have my voice right now. Hallelujah. I know him in being the God of all comfort. When I was crying and having all kinds of issues with grieving with my mother leaving, I can tell you about that God. I can tell you about the God who provides when I couldn't figure out how to pay a bill and it was necessary and it was the ninth hour and it came from nowhere to somewhere. I can tell you about that experience, that partiality of my God. I need to give that knowledge of my God. Hallelujah. I need to be shining. Oh, glory be unto God. The glory, the doxa, the kabah of God. The word, some people say, doxa means the opinion or the estimate of God. What is your opinion of your God? Every time I holler glory, I'm giving God my opinion of it. What is your opinion of your God? What has he revealed to you, for you, and is revealing through you? Glory be unto God. Dr. Dokia says it's a thought or it's an opinion, especially one that is a favorable, meaning praise and honor and splendor and light and rewards and all of that. God's opinion makes true the value of things as they appear in the eternal mind. Hallelujah. But we got to recognize that we on our side of things, we tend to be willy-washy. We tend to be willy-washy. We give value to something today and tomorrow we throw it away. Yeah, but that God is not like that. Hallelujah. Yes. We must let our heart rest so we can give all we do. No, to God. Come on, somebody. Thank you, Sister Tamara. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we have to talk about, we have to showcase the character of our God. Yeah, I like that. We got to showcase the character of our God. That's giving the knowledge of his glory. Hallelujah. His value. And where is it said seen? The value. It says the glory is being seen what? In the face. Didn't Sister Keta talk to us about that face? In the face of Jesus Christ, in the face. Hallelujah. That word is postponed, means toward. But God's grace abounds toward us. Hallelujah. Yes, ma'am. Showcase the character of our God. Literally, the face, the organ of sight, the face. You know what? I can tell how my husband is, how he's feeling, whatever, by his face.
Come on now. Come on.
He looks at me a certain way. I can talk to him and never use a word just by looking at his face.
Come on.
So you can understand that when it's saying the glory of God is in the face of Jesus, look at what kind of face he's looking at toward you. Hallelujah. Ooh, when you're looking at the face of God, he said, when you see me, you've seen the Father. Hallelujah. If we want to know what God is like, look at the face of Jesus. Look at the one that even though they were plucking the whiskers out of his face, even though they were crushing thorns down into his skull, he never said a mumbling word. He never, ever rebuked them. Look at the face of Jesus. Look at the face when he saw a widow carrying her son to the graveyard. And he knew that she had no one to support her, and he stopped them and raised the boy up. Hallelujah. Look at the face of Jesus when the woman came to him with the issue. She'd given up everything, everything she had. She had no more hope. The only thing she had left, she said, if I can just get to him and just touch his clothes, touch the hem of his garment, touch the name of God, if I can just get to him, then I will be healed. And he said, not only are you healed, but you're made whole, daughter. Hallelujah. Then look at the face of Jesus, who went to the centurion, talked to the centurion when other folks ain't, you know, we don't talk to our enemies. Mm-hmm, he did. Look at the face of Jesus, who went to the Roman's house and healed the daughter. Jairus was not Hebrew. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Look at Jesus, who would meet you at night if you were too scared to come in the daytime, Nicodemus. Look at Jesus. Look at the face of God, who will meet you where you are and give you the light, the power to understand his over-encompassing, all-encompassing, uncomprehensible love. So what is our job? Light and shine out of darkness. Matthew says you are the light of the world, as Sister Keta said. A city that's set on a hill can't be hid. Listen, if that light is shining before you, then your spot, what God is telling you right now, is that I have caused the power of understanding and the luminosity of my character, of who I am, of how I am, of whose you are, to rest in your heart. And it is your job to give knowledge of that and in the face of Jesus. So our job is to shine by giving the knowledge that we have of God to others. Hallelujah. That's our job.
Yeah, hallelujah.
It's time to shine, y'all. And it doesn't stop. It's a continue. I told you the out of and the into was with movement. But what goes in, we keep. Hallelujah. So since we have this ministry, we will not lose heart. We won't consider how we're being talked about. We won't consider how we're being misunderstood. We won't consider all of the naysayer and the yay yayers and all of that. We won't consider that, because our job is to shine, to give forth the knowledge of the glory of God in Christ Jesus, the character of God. It's time to showcase the character of our God. And how do we showcase it? By what? Being the moon. What do I mean by that? The moon has no light of itself. It just reflects the sun. We have no light in ourselves. We reflect what God has placed in us. It's time to be the moon. It's time to shine. Hallelujah. Renounce the hidden things, the deceitful things. It's time to let it go. It's time to let go of the craftiness, preachers. All that trickery and divisiveness and all that little stuff that we do to try to get glory for ourselves. It's not about our glory. It's about his glory and his story in our lives. Come on, somebody. It's time to manifest the truth. For we know that if our gospel be hid, it is hidden by those who the God of this earth age has blinded. Not saying that they're innocent. Ah, yes, that's right. Be a reflector of the light, Sister Marylene. But scripture tells us in John 3:19, and she mentioned it. Sister Keta mentioned it. She said, light is coming to the world, but men love darkness. Why? Because their deeds were evil and they wanted to hide. But when we walk, we have to expose the light. Yes, let the critter scatter. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. The God of this age is trying to hold those back. But if we begin to walk, if we just walk into the room and let the Spirit of the Lord shine through us, it will dispel the darkness. For God has commanded that the light would shine out of the obscurity of darkness. Come on, somebody, let your light so shine before men that they may see what God is doing in your life. And then give God glory. Hallelujah. Let's not keep preaching ourselves, but let's start preaching Christ. He's given us the display. He's given us the picture. He's given us the representation. And we stand with Jesus, as he said in John 17, 24. Father, glorify me so that they may behold my glory that you have given me. Give it back to God. Give it back to God. I think that's it. Hallelujah. Yep, I think that's it. There's a whole lot more here, but God has, the Spirit of the Lord has shut down. He said, that's it. And I got sense enough to shut up when he says, bring it down. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. To glory be to God. That's so awesome. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for the word, Dr. Carey. Thank you for walking through that. Thank you so much. That's just beautiful. Thank you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Awesome. Thank you.
Amen, Dr. Carey. Powerful message. I hope you saw my message. I'm about to pass out over here. Yeah. I was about to pass out. Oh, Dr. Carey, thank you for walking, taking your time and ministering to us what God has given you in your secret place with him. And it shows, and we needed this. I know I needed it. And it was so yummy and good. I just wanted more, but I know you had to do it, be obedient, but this was so good. Everything was just so divinely orchestrated. And I'm so glad God took you to doing something new, doing something, going, taking you in a way you never been right now. Yes. And so I'm so glad you were obedient to the word of God, this was so good. I can't wait till we can watch the replay. I'm going to go back and take, because you was going fast too. You was going, I had my pee. I said, oh, I that's guess I right. See what people, I know what people be saying about me now. I said, wait a minute. I said, wait a minute. She said, EK, you done went on to the cardio with the K. And I said, I said, Lord, I'm just going to go back and get the replay. I get my notes from there. But it was so yummy. Thank you so much. This was so needed, so relevant, and so timely. I love you so much for just being so obedient. Mm-mm-mm. And see what God did. And y'all, she is so right. We were laughing and talking because I got my message yesterday at 6 in the afternoon, my scripture message, but I didn't finish it until this morning, 4 in the morning. And I got up and she told me she ain't go to bed till 6 in the morning. And I said, wow, you know, it's just awesome. Yeah. And it's just to see, you can just sort of see the, even if y'all, you know, you could just see the, what you call it, the continuity, put it like that, the continuity of the flow of the Holy Spirit. In the words, both messages that were brought to today, they just so were so complimentary. They were so complimentary of each other. Yes, and that's why this is just so rich. Oh, this was so good. I thank you that you my leader, and God bless you.
Amen.
Yes. Father God, I just thank you for the teaching that has come today. Lord, I have sat at the feet of Jesus and I have gleaned so richly from the teaching, Father. Thank you for letting me be a part of these godly women. Thank you for the light, Father, that comes from you and nothing can stop it. Lord, what an encouragement as we live in today's society where everything around us looks this way and looks that way. And yet we can look at you and we can say, oh, Father, the light that comes from you is overwhelming. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you for this word. I pray a blessing on every woman that is here, Father, in the mighty, mighty name of my Savior, Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Awesome.
Amen. My sweet Carrie, thank you.
You're welcome. You're so welcome. One of the things of you, those of you that are new on the line that don't know, we're interactive. We let people share whatever. Amen. Awesome closing prayer. Yes, it was, Sister Cherry. Amen. Tariq. Hallelujah. We allow time for people to express what God is saying to them, or if they have a question, or if they have a prayer request. And that's what why, you know, we're just here for a moment basking in this word. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Glory.
Glory, glory.
No limits, right? No limits.
No restriction. That no was
restriction.
No restriction.
Be open. Like Keta said, be open to
be open.
Things in a powerful new way. And he did that, Minister Carrie. He did that. He did that today. He showed you in a powerful new way. That I know virtual is just, you know, everybody's doing it now, but it's still new if you've never done it before. So that, and it was awesome. It was awesome with all the technicality and even with the distraction with your voice and trying to steal your voice. It just shows how good and how great and powerful our God is and how his light does shine through all forms of darkness, even illness and voices given out on us and headaches and everything else. Have to be doing something else. Save on some time here because we're redeeming the time in his word. So God is so good and so awesome that we can do that, and the day will still hold itself. Why? Because we're taking time for God and his word with his ladies. And that's what I'm talking about.
Come on now.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I'm excited. I took some time. And I am so blessed. I'm more than blessed for it because I was supposed to have been gone hours ago. But this time has been better than me going out and trying to earn a dollar because, hallelujah, my God is able to supply all of my
needs. Come on now.
His riches in glory. I ain't trying to preach, y'all, but you know it's from my mouth. So I'm going to
girl.
Amen.
That's it.
Woo! Right. I'm excited.
Keta,
like Minister
Keta
say, I'm excited about Jesus.
Woo.
Yes. Amen.
Call his name, sister. Call his name.
Woo.
Amen.
Thank you both for such a good, honest, and heartfelt, and sitting at the feet of God, waiting for his word. And I thank you for that.
Amen.
You can't count out the men that are on here too. Remember, there's some men on here.
Oh, yes. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to exclude you guys because I love my brother Christ. Hallelujah. Woo!
Dr. K, I just want to say too, you know, we started off, I had my camera off, and the songbird who sung that song. I wanted to say that, like, yes. I wanted to pass out. Me, I just was crying. I had to fall because that's one of my testimonial songs, truly. Mm-hmm. And I remember about a month ago, I called the girl who does my hair, my sister in Christ, Leslie, and I said, she's a songbird, she has that gift. And I called her from work one day, and you know, y'all know the breastfeeding room. the breastfeeding room is my sanctuary at work. I go in there and I sit in there and I the door, and that is where I do my meditation or prayers or whatever, just doing my work, do my lunch hour. So I called Leslie and I said, Leslie, I need to hear that song. And I took the phone in there, she sung it, and I just cried and I just cried and cried. And when she sung that song today, it was the same reaction. I was like, oh, I'm so glad I don't got the camera on. And I was just crying and wiping my eyes, and I was in worship, and the glory was just here, and just, you know, being able to adore God and just be in my special place with him. Just, she was, everything was just so, she was just anointed. Her minister over her was blessed with the word that he even shared with
her.
Dancers that we started off with, and then even the young other lady, sister who was dancing. We know it's just a little lag, but it was still just all orchestrated, and it was still glory. You know, they got in the glory. It was just so moving. Just the experience of you know, to experience all of that virtually, just as if I was in the building, as if I was, we were under one roof. It is how I was feeling, and I was just so moved by all of the presentation, just everybody who had a
chance to participate. Even your apostle who opened up and shared and talked with us and encouraged. It just was so anointed. Just, whew, this is yummy. This is a gumdrop for the soul, Miss Mary.
Yes, it is, girl.
Yes,
something yes, sweet yes. to chew on. Yes, 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 yes. Woo!
Yes,
that's the gumdrop for today.
Oh yeah, we can chew on this for a while. That's right.
Yes. And definitely. Then Miss Mary, thank you for introducing me, because basically you said the same thing that I sent to Dr. White, basically. So it was just all you was flowing into it. All of it was in unison. So thank you. Thank you, my friend.
I thank you for that. Now the Carrie put me on the spot, so when she called my name the first time, I started praying. So definitely my honor, bigger honor for me to introduce you, because I know you as my friend, my teacher, and my leader. So I'll just be better blessed for it.
Amen.
Anyone else? We won't belabor the time, but I want to make sure that everyone has the opportunity to share their heart. If they have something they want to say, please feel free. Amen.
And you said, when is the next one, Dr. Carey?
Next year?
No.
Oh, July.
July. Fourth Saturday in July, which I think is the 23rd.
Oh, it's my son's birthday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, all right.
Dr. Carey, this is Marie. Lakeitha, I got on late, but girl. My God, when I got on, I was like, my God, that was such a powerful, powerful and timely. I mean, my God, it spoke volumes and volumes and volumes, and gave me a new charge. So amen. You know, glory to God.
Amen.
We are so glad you made it, Sister Marie. Yes, 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 yes. All our hearts go out. Amen. I'm excited about everybody that was on here. Amen. Mm-hmm. Everybody that's here by Facebook, not Facebook, by YouTube. I'm so used to saying Facebook. By YouTube.
Right.
Amen. By Zoom. And those that listen, this will be, the recording is on our church ministry page, our church YouTube channel. And anyone that is public. So if you want to share it, feel free. Amen.
Good.
You know, once it's done, I have to put, I guess, some notes or whatever, but on it. But it will be public and available to anyone for replay. To share it out. Praise the Lord, because guess what? This was his conference. He filled up my cup. Yeah.
Yes, he did fill our cup. He overflowed it.
Thank you for sharing that, because I was going to ask you, where can I catch the rest of the message?
Okay.
Yeah, because my friend had to leave, and I told her I'll find out for her how to get the recording too.
And hold on, I think I might can. I don't know if you guys can copy it from the chat, but this is do do do, and I'll probably make a bit.ly link. Y'all know how I am. I'll probably make
with them bit.lys.
But that's the link right now for the live. Okay.
Oh boy.
On YouTube. But I'll probably do a bit.ly link for it. And I'll
do a bit.ly link.
And you guys can share it out. Amen. So I would love it if my Apostle Ramon, I know I'm putting you on the spot again, but would you close us out? I mean, you know, hey, you know I love you, my brother. You know it.
I love you too. Well, hopefully, excuse me, everybody has thoroughly enjoyed themselves on today.
Yes.
I truly have. And trust me, I'm like many of you. I'm glad I was muted and video was off, because I took off running in my house. I'm tell you, between Dr. White and the other woman who spoke, y'all almost made me have to go get my asthma pump.
Wow.
I tell y'all, awesome, awesome. And I want to encourage every woman that's on this line. Never let male chauvinists make you feel you are not worthy or qualified to bring the word of God. Because we have to understand that the word was brought forth by a woman by the name of Mary.
That's right. Say that. Oh my God. That's right.
She had the first message. She preached salvation to the world and didn't even know it. So I encourage every woman on the line, keep doing what you're doing. If you're not received, keep preaching, keep prophesying, keep evangelizing, keep pastoring, whatever the Lord's calling is for you on your life, keep living it, because I am a living example of sitting under a woman leader. So I pray that everybody's cup was overfilled on today. Amen. And if all hearts and minds are clear, we'll go ahead and close out in prayer. And again, Dr. White, congratulations. I am so proud of you. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time of fellowship. We thank you for this time of coming together. We thank you for this time of allowing us to come together, not based on denomination, not based on gender, not based on office, not based on ideologies, but coming together one in the Spirit, God. Father, we thank you for allowing us to be able to fellowship one with another, pour into one another, receive from one another. Father God, this weekend, God, was a success. And we serve the devil notice. Every interference, every distraction, every attempt you made to disrupt and destroy what God had designed for today, it failed. So, Father, as we depart this conference, God, and we go our respective ways, God, continue to watch over us as we travel our daily routes, paths, whatever we have to do this weekend. Father, continue to watch over us as we prepare for our respective services on Sunday. And Father, we thank you, and we give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. And those of you that can join me, we will be having a service at 3 o'clock on tomorrow evening. The link is bit.ly/RHOFINC, all caps. Bit.ly is case sensitive, okay? So RHOFINC. And or you can join me on Facebook, on our Facebook page. We will be live streaming into the Facebook page for Refined Heart Outreach. And that also is RHOFINC. So we thank you all. My heart is just so full, and I'm so honored that you allowed God to use me to speak to you today. For all of my participants and presenters, you know what? God's blessing be upon you. Amen. And we say, have a super fantastic afternoon. I love you.